Hi everybody, it's Eugene Licio, and today I'd like to show you a little bit about how you can use your iPhone or the iPhone video to create a dense point cloud. Now, one of the things you're going to need obviously is a video, which I've done here of a tree trunk. And so really all I'm doing is trying to stay at about a constant distance around the tree trunk, close enough to pick up some pretty good details. And I also want to come back around to the other side and make sure that I have a little bit of overlap from the position where I first started. So you'll see that slowly as this comes to the end here. And there we go. Okay, so I'm going to be using Visual SFM, and one of the things that you need are images. So you have to be able to extract individual images from the video. Now, fortunately, QuickTime Pro actually comes with the ability to export an image sequence. So there you go. I mean, there's a lot of other options, but we're going to choose image sequence, and I'm also going to go to the options, and you'll see that I have a number of different image options. I'm going to stick with JPEG. In frames per second, you can choose 30, 25, whatever, but obviously the more single images you use, or the higher the frame rate, then you're going to obviously really build up a whole lot of images. So we don't want to be waiting here forever. For this example, we're going to use 5 images per second. I've already done this, so I know that that's a good number. And really what you're trying to do is balance between the number of images and processing time, and also the distance between each images. If the frame rate is too low, and let's say the camera was moving faster, the distance or the images might be too dissimilar that you might not get a lot of good feature matches. So the closer they are together, definitely the more feature matches you'll get, but you have to balance that also with the amount of time, how much processing time you're willing to accept. So I'm going to just say go ahead. I'm in this folder called tree, and I'm just going to call this, I don't know, tree underscore, and it will automatically assign some numbers. So I'm going to hit save, and it's starting to export that. And I will bring up the, when that's done, okay, so let me just bring up the folder here, and you can see here that it wrote, let's see how many, 134 different images, so great. Now, what we want to do is get back to Visual SFM, and there's really 4 steps to Visual SFM. The first is really to load all the images, so I'm just going to hit Control A and hit Open. And all the images get loaded up here, and in a second I should be able to see them all. There they are. Okay, so there's all the 134 different images. The second step is that I want to compute all the relationships, or the features relationships, between one photos to the other. Now, because this is video and all the images are sequential, there's a feature under SFM for pairwise matching, compute sequence match. So I want to do that, and also what I would like to do is tell it how many photos in a row should it be looking for a match. So you can choose as many as you like, but obviously as the number increases, if you go 10 frames forward, the images might be dissimilar enough that you'll have very few feature matches. So I'm gonna stick with 4 for this particular quick project here, and I'm just gonna hit OK, and it will now go ahead and start processing all the images for the feature matching. So I'm just gonna hit pause here and let it go. It's probably only gonna take a minute or two, and then I'll switch it back on when it's done. Okay, so it actually didn't take very long at all. It looks like it took about 26 seconds or so, and so now I have all my features matched. But what I need to do is do like a kind of like a 3D reconstruction or a sparse reconstruction using all those feature matched points. So all I need to do is just hit that button right here, and off it goes. And you'll see that it actually starts to construct as matching all the features together, and then putting the camera positions in there. And slowly you'll see some of the camera positions coming through. I'm going to let this do its thing as well, and again, probably only take a couple of minutes, and then we'll do the dense reconstruction from there. Okay, so it took a couple of minutes to finish, but you can see that I've got all the little bits of single images that I have. So you can see how I've the path that I've sort of traced around the tree trunk, and the overlap as well. Now, on this particular tree trunk, actually I can increase the size of these points. If you want to know what I'm doing here, I'm just hitting the control and mouse wheel for the image sizes or camera positions, and alt and mouse wheel in order to get the point sizes larger and smaller. So this is great. I've got the sparse point cloud done. If that's all you need, then you can obviously export these points and do some things with it. If not, and you want to move on, the next step is to use the CMVS, PMVS. A little bit note about this. If you want to change the settings, all you have to do is hit the enter and type in set, and the settings file comes up. And so you can change some of the PMVS, CMVS settings are here. Now I'm just going to stick with the default settings that I have, and I'm going to hit OK. Now if for whatever reason you do change that and you run at this point, you actually need to reload all the settings. So just go to SFM, More Functions, Reload All Settings, and once you do that, you'll have the latest changes saved and included in the CMVS processing. So I'm just going to hit CMVS, go ahead. It asks, hey, where do you want to save this stuff? I'm just going to call it Tree Video, something like that. Hit Save, and it will start by undistorting the images, and it's obviously going to take a little bit of time. Actually, it may not take even that long, but I'm just going to pause this for a little bit, and then we'll go from there. And we're back. It only took about 39 seconds to process all of that, and if you want to get to the dense reconstruction in Visual SFM, just hit the Tab key, and there you go. You have your dense reconstruction. Now I can see that there's some noise here that's coming off of part of the trunk, and this wasn't here, and I'm not exactly sure what this is, but because I'm using video, relatively low res, and I'm moving, there could be some blurring and some other problems because of the movement or some jerky movement, things like that. So, but that's easily cleaned up. If you know, if you're using this for visualization, certainly not a big deal, something you can fix quite easily in MeshLab or whatever that might be. Now, in the directory that you just saved, there is a models file. I can show you this here. So I chose the name of Tree Video, so just go to this folder, 00, and then under Models, and you'll see that there's a PLY file here. And if you load this up into MeshLab, you'll be able to visualize the point cloud. So that's pretty much how you do it from start to finish. Not that bad, not that difficult. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks.